to get. It's just feeding off the practice.
Right.
And you don't get hurt.
Yes. Well, it's kind of like for like UFC fighters and strikers to spar and have decent real sparring in. But more and more, they're talking about, it's like, do I need to know that I can take a punch? Like, right. As long as you know you can bring ferocity, you're going to benefit more from light sparring.
Yeah.
And I feel like with flow rolling, it's, you know, especially like if a new person can actually flow roll, it's going to be safer. They'll be able to practice like the shit that they're learning. You're able
those
to...
peepholes will become windows.
Right. And for someone like me, I keep reverting back to my flexibility. It gives me an opportunity to drill my fundamentals and the techniques I'm learning and not revert back to what I'm comfortable with. Right. So just like a beginner.
Right. Get those reps in. In real time.
In real time.
Yeah. Big fan. Big fan.
No, I'm super down. I think that would be cool. Go like really light flow roll, like a warm-up round. And then like an actual round. And then a flow round. And then like rotate to a new partner or something. Mm-hmm. Or just death battle and then flow roll. Because then you can flow roll and work on.
Right.
Like...
I think the first warm-up round would be good for, like, the very, very start. Like,
but not every single partner.
This is the first round. Everyone do a flow round first. And then everything after that is just the two.
Well, you could even set a timer for, like, 6 minutes. And then, like, at the three-minute mark, just be like, and it's a flow roll time. Mm-hmm. Now that you're all pissed at each other. Like, and dial it back.
Right. That's good for emotional control, too.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yes, jiu-jitsu.
Fuck yes.
Dude, I'm so happy you got into jiu-jitsu.
I'm happy you got into jiu-jitsu as well.
Like, there's the there's decisions where it's like a life before this decision and a life after this decision. That's one of those decisions.
Yeah.
Like moving to Colorado, there's life before Colorado, life after. And this is one of the subsets in the life after.
Right. Well, I was thinking about too, like, you know how we were talking about like the jiu-jitsu family being like a driving factor to staying in Westminster and stuff. And like, I think with anything too, the culture behind it like helps you stay motivated. Because like how we were saying, like people come to jiu-jitsu for different reasons and stuff. Like there is the social aspect of it and whatnot. I don't know. Like if we had a really shitty instructor or something and I had shitty classmates or something, right. Jiu-jitsu wouldn't be what it is for me now.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like even though it's the exact same technique, same sport, same self-defense, it is what it is because of the people involved. Mm-hmm. And that definitely, I think, plays a direct correlation into my motivation for wanting to go every day.
Right. I saw a guy at the gym yesterday and he was like, now that you won't be working here, don't just stop going to the gym. Like, the difference with that is I don't go to the gym for, like, vanity reasons or whatever. I go to the gym to get better at stuff, other stuff that I do.
Right.
It's to help my performance and other...
It's a boost things. In life.
Right. It's not just going to the gym just to lift. It's going to the gym to get better at jiu-jitsu, to get better at hiking, to get better at whatever else I'm doing, and to lift. That's like not the main reason. I have other
It's very low on the totem pole of priority.
Right. I have other motivations to go to the gym.
Yeah.
Just like I always say with diet, it's easy to stay strict on your diet when the things, your hobbies rely on how well you perform. Like if I eat a fat pizza before a competition, I know I'm not going to perform as well.
Right.
But if I eat a fat ribeye before competition, I know it's going to help me out.
Right.
It's easier just to not eat like an asshole when your hobbies depend on it.
Well, and it's like, it goes back to like, if I'm driving like a sports car or something, I don't want to put like just bullshit fuel into it and then go to a race.
Right.
But it's like, on a micro level, if you fuel yourself every single day with good stuff, it, like, your body's gonna follow suit.
Right. Right.
That being said, I am about to lift just purely for vanity. Hopefully, it'll make me strong.
It won't. You know what'll make you strong?
Recording this conversation because we always forget to.
Yes. Powerlifting will make you strong and jacked. So.
And swim around Europe.
And swim around Europe. Yes. Tony, man, you should listen to that podcast. It's a good one.
I'm going to.
It's a good one. It's motivating in itself.
It'll make you jacked, short, and British.
And a better beard. He has a good-ass beard, too.